we kind of bounce onto this other video that I saw on the Joe Rogan subreddit, which I think is fairly interesting, in that I mentioned before, I think in general, we've really kind of haven't even got to grips or understanding how much COVID has broken our brains collectively as a society, especially in the Western world. I feel like we just could never get our heads around the idea of doing something for the collective good, because we live in an individualistic society. If you ever watch Hypernormalization or any other Adam Curtis documentary, you would know exactly what I'm talking about. And we just couldn't get ourselves in a position where we would maybe suspend suspicion and maybe just agree to disagree and just all collectively get the vaccine and just move on with our everyday lives. We couldn't do it, which is why all these clubs around the world, or around Europe for the most part, nightclubs specifically for my interest, are slowly but surely starting to open in spits and spurts, right? You've got news about Holland opening up soon. I think I saw something about Oslo. I saw something about Ibiza opening up in limited hours. Like, there is a, how do you say, there is definitely a difference in approach based on each country and based on the temperament of people that live there. But in general, collectively, as a Western world, we've just found it hard to just say kumbaya, put differences to one side, let's fight this greater good. Because you'd imagine, again, off the back of all the political unrest, especially in the States, you'd think that COVID would be the great unifier to bring people together. But if anything, it drove them even further apart. And so this clip is from, again, from the Joe Rogan podcast, where he's basically pondering why more people aren't as healthy as him, especially off the back of COVID, especially with the fact that so many random people are passing away. Unfortunately, I think we had a story here in the UK about a girl that was like 15 who unfortunately passed away from COVID, even though she was due to get a jab on the same day. Like, proper tragic shit. But yeah, we just haven't necessarily figured out how to get our heads around it, and Joe Rogan seems to be confused as to why people aren't as committed to health and fitness as much as he is, despite him having the ability to basically not care about anything else in his life outside of his family and working out, and the fact that he takes all those other cocktails of drugs and shit in it. So this is a part of the way I think, in some respects, some people's brains have been broken through COVID in one way, and this is maybe Joe Rogan's way of his head being broken by COVID. Maybe I'm wrong, but maybe I'm wrong. Who knows?
When people are sick, the thing that they want more than anything is to be healthy. They're like, oh my God, I wish I was healthy. But then once they get healthy, they go back to the same eating habits, the same just, you know, just sedentary lifestyle, drinking alcohol, cigarettes, all the same shit that got them in the mess in the first place. And they don't change much about their nutrition. They don't change much about their exercise habits, when it has such a massive effect on the quality of your life, the longevity of your ability to exercise. Like, I'm 54 now, and I really haven't lost any ability to exercise rigorously, to do it the same way. And I've done a lot of, like, weird, like, one of the things that I did is I completed that Israeli protocol for hyperbaric chambers, where you did 90 days. I did 60 sessions of 90 minutes over 90 days. What's supposed to lengthen your telomere.
I like how he's trying to do a humble brag about doing some Israeli protocol thing that he obviously brought up because he wanted to sound cool, but he didn't want to sound too cool. It's like, gotta love Joe, innit? Proper bro energy.
That's appropriate to, or approximate to, a 20-year decrease in your biological age. I did that. I just did it.
Wow.
Just finished it. And I feel great. I don't know what it did. I mean, I didn't really measure.
It's funny that he's talking about this sort of stuff to a woman, right? Like, describing his fitness and workout protocol, when I'd assume most women, unless they're professional athletes, couldn't give a shit.
Measure my telomeres, and I probably should now. But there's definitely something that happens when you do something like that. But who the fuck has time for that? Like, who's going to do that? How many people are going to be committed to, like, going to some stupid place and lying in a metal chamber for 90 days?
You're an outlier. That.
And also, most people just don't care, and they have other stresses and worries in their life they have to kind of think about other than working out. And I guess, again, that's the benefit of having fuck you money. The benefit of having fuck you money, what it actually should be doing, again, like I said before, I think the same thing that could be argued about gays nowadays being boring. I think there's a lot of conversation I see around some of the podcasts I listen to about gay culture not being as interesting as it was in the 80s and maybe parts of the 90s, when it was maybe a bit more dangerous, a bit more risque. And the fact that it's become so, I guess, a kind of, I won't say quite normal part of society, but in, especially in the Western world, it's no one really bats an eyelid that much around the gay discourse or the queer discourse or the LGBT discourse at all, as they did in the past, which is amazing, especially growing up in a very African traditional family. It's cool to see, or conservative family, it's cool to see that that conversation has been broadened out a little bit more and all that good stuff. But similar to that, rich people just aren't as interesting or as exciting, especially newly minted rich people, as they were in the past. They're just fairly boring, fairly middle of the road, fairly vanilla. They kind of do everything in clandestine. They don't really talk about the shit that they enjoy. They don't really talk to people like you and I. They kind of just hang out in their own little silos, pay no taxes and do their thing. So it is quite impressive to see somebody like a Joe Rogan using his newly found wealth, which he kind of accumulated, I guess you'd say, from the news radio days all the way up, right, which is maybe late 20s, early 30s, but still he wasn't kind of born into a rich family. It's cool to see him using that money as a way to kind of do the things that he actually enjoys, right? Like, yeah, I think he talks about all the time about how when he started making a lot of money, he'd always take his friends out to dinner, right? So now everyone knows whenever Joe Rogan invites you to dinner, he's gonna pay, he's gonna tip huge, you order what the fuck you want, and it's just gonna be a great time, innit? Cool, amazing. But most people don't do that. Most people get Scrooge McDuck when it comes to their money and they're, you know, newly minted, you know, because they start to kind of believe in their own sort of they start to believe in their own sort of narrative, right? That they are I did this on my own, and you could just need to pull yourself up by your bootstraps. And they kind of just develop contempt for people who are quote unquote beneath them, which is flipping bizarre to say the least, isn't it? Because that usually does happen, right? The more working class you are, background wise, or middle class, and the more affluent you become later in your life, the more you start to despise the very same people you came from, or the very same community of people that you came from. Absolutely nutty behavior. But yeah, I respect Joe Rogan for that respect. I respect Joe Rogan for that aspect, sorry, not that respect. And I'm also a big fan of the fact that, especially when it comes to this COVID conversation, again, he's one of the only voices out there really talking about health and fitness in the way that he does. Now, again, it can be a bit annoying. It can be a bit boring. It can be a bit smooth brained. It can be a bit repetitive, right? Joe Rogan, he's got a couple of anecdotes and stories. Just keeps repeating them ad nauseum. But still, it's still refreshing to see somebody say that out loud, that, hey, maybe we should maybe think about, you know, our diets and how we work out, our relationship with food, whatever. We need to figure something out, because the amount of people that are passing away from COVID, especially now, maybe before when we didn't have much information and we're still figuring stuff out, but the fact that we've got all these alternative treatments, we have vaccinations coming out of our asses, we have, you know, I'm sure medical protocols in the hospitals have improved too. Many things are going on that basically improve the situation that we're in, and we still can't seem to figure it out, right? It just, I don't know, man, it just fills me with dread. But it's also kind of interesting as well, on the other side of it, to think of, even though I can see the negative and the positive for this guy, it's also funny to think of all the failed romantic relationships I've suffered from off the back of liking Joe Rogan and Jordan Peterson. Women really dislike this dude, which I understand, because most women hate Gwyneth Paltrow, right? It's the same thing. So she's basically the female Joe Rogan, especially with a good brand. I'm surprised she hasn't been on the Joe Rogan Experience just yet. If she has the shit before, I'm not sure. But yeah, it's the same thing. I think men just recognize the overly feminine energy that comes out of, or borderline PPD maybe, who knows, that comes out of Gwyneth Paltrow's pores, in the same way women notice the kind of hyper cis male energy that comes out of Rogan's pores too, right? They just want it to get away from them, which I understand, I get completely. But again, respect for Joe Rogan for that, but still, he has to realize that the reason why he can work out so much at his age is because legitimately he doesn't have as many life stresses as most people do have, which again, he's worked hard for, don't get me wrong, but you can't equate his ability to work out and the ability for just a regular 54-year-old guy that works in IT and has a kid he hasn't seen in ages, a wife that despises him. I mean, it's just not the same thing. He's not going to have time to do flipping Turkish get-ups. You know what I mean? He has to legitimately go pick up his kid because he's not sure if this is going to be the last time he ever sees him, because his mum threatened to move away. Do you know what I mean? Like, that's the realness of real people's lives. But, you know, what do I know? What do I know?